You've heard it said, blank. Like, nothing. Right? Like you were struggling, maybe you developed a porn addiction or you developed some other thing and you're just struggling with something and you go to church and maybe, I mean, because you're a Christian, you're a follower of Christ, you really want to serve faithfully, but you're feeling these things going on inside of you and you wait for somebody to say something and they don't. You hear nothing. Dr. Julie Slattery, she has I said I was going to do it first service and I forgot. Has a website called AuthenticIntimacy.com. Great, great website, a lot of great resources, solid biblical teaching around sexuality as well. But in her book, Rethinking Sexuality, she says this, for generations, the church simply didn't talk about things such as sexual addiction, sexual abuse, sexual dysfunction, or even sexual pleasure in marriage. And the people were left to navigate that terrain on their own. Last week, or the first week that we started this series, After I finished second service, I walked down. There's a lady walked up to me and she said, Pastor, I've been in the church for over 50 years and I have not one time heard a message about sexuality like what you shared today. She said, I've heard bits and pieces about fornication and adultery and those kind of things, but I've really just never heard about this, about God's plan for sexuality, God's design and his purpose for sexuality. So I'm sorry if you spent half your life in church and never heard about God's design and plan for sex. I'm sorry if you struggled with porn, but the church didn't know how to help you, and so you just didn't say anything. I'm sorry if the church's silence on sex made you think that somehow it was shameful. I'm sorry if the church was silent about sex and led you to find answers in other places that weren't just unreliable, but they were kind of destructive. I'm sorry about that.